Welcome to episode 4 of Claws and Convo. I'm your host and producer, Striker Chigwar, totally overwhelmed as usual, but yeah, that's kind of what you deal with in here, kind of working on the show alone. Anyway, today's episode is going to be a free-for-all once again, because we don't have anything specifically set for the topic-wise, and I expect there's not going to be a whole lot of news either, so yeah, it's just going to be a hangout type of show. We do have one little thing to feature. It's the radio story called Kaze, Winds of Change. You may remember a little animated short that came out a few years ago called Kaze Shadow Warrior, and they have just released their first episode of Winds of Change, and from what I've heard of it, from this episode that I have heard, it is every bit of what I expected, if not more. So we're going to be listening to that later on, but in the meantime, yeah, I meant to do episode 4 on Halloween, but, you know, with no one watching and no real reason to really care. Go away, Tweet Deck. Actually, I should probably tweet the show's on now. Show is on now! /stream/stream Claws and Convo. There we go. Close that so it doesn't make noises of annoyance. So, anyway, right. So yeah, as I was saying, episode 4, this is sort of a re-airing of episode 4, rebroadcast, redoing of episode 4, because I rage quit last week. Didn't get a whole lot of sleep, and the editing program kept crashing, so that never made it, the recorded version never made it to YouTube, never saw the light of day, so here we are, episode 4, here on November 7th, 2014. So, yeah, I just recently registered for Midwest Firefest, which is one of the largest conventions in the United States. It's held at Rosemont, Illinois, at the O'Hare Hyatt, Regency O'Hare. The words are all there, just out of order. I'm stumbling on my words today. Like that's something new. Yeah. So yes, Midwest Firefest in Rosemont, Illinois, at the Hyatt O'Hare Regency Hotel. And they actually, this year is going to be the first one in December, but normally it's been held previously in November, but due to some conflicts with stuff going on, and of course the constantly growing attendance, they had to reschedule, and they have settled on December 5th through the 7th, and I will be attending this year. And not only will I be attending, but I will be in fursuit. So, and it's going to be my first time in fursuit, so it's going to be rather exciting. Rather, it's going to be a new experience for me. And I think, some people enjoy the con out of suits. Some people might have a better time in the suit, depending on the type of personality. And I feel like I'm going to be one of those people who enjoys the con more in suit, because I'm extremely introverted in public. And, yeah. So, I digress. So, let's talk about Midwest Fur Fest for just a moment. Pre-registration is still open. Well, unfortunately, if you haven't registered yet, you've missed the discounted early pre-reg price, but it's still highly recommended that you pre-reg while you still can. Because lines really suck. Trust me. If you've never been to a convention, and I would say Midwest Fur Fest is a very good, it's a very good convention for your first con. Albeit it is rather large, and it is quickly growing. It's actually catching up with AnthroCon. I would guess it's probably the third largest convention in the world right now. Behind the Eurofronts, which is in Germany. Eurofronts, by the way, is the longest running convention of the furry. Continuously running. But, that would be the second largest. And often claimed to be the best. I'd love to go there someday. That'd be awesome if I could get over there and attend your friends. It's on the bucket list. But, that's second largest. And, of course, the largest is AnthroCon, which seems to be a little more of a type of con if to go to if you're not really a furry, but you're kind of curious. AnthroCon might be the con to go to first if you've never been anywhere near anything furry at all in your life. It's more of a broader type of con. It's a little more mainstream at AnthroCon, so it might be a little more accessible to the general public. Most furry conventions, they do tend to be somewhat accessible to the general public. Of course, always welcome to any convention, and come in, check it out. Just don't fuck with us. Just FYI. FYI. So you know, yeah. There's no music playing in the background. Why is that? Let's fix that. There we go. Background music. Right. So, see who what was the programming? Let's see, guest of honor. Who is a guest of honor? Meta's Fur Fest has selected Critter Camp as their 2014 charity. Very nice. Nick and Lacey from fursuiting.com are guests of honor, along with Sabretooth Ermine, excellent artist, and D. Walker, another excellent artist. So, good stuff, good stuff. So, furfest.org, December 5th through 7th, Rosemont, Illinois. Regency O'Hare Hyatt. Regency Hyatt O'Hare. However that's ordered. I don't know. My head's kind of scattered. Yeah. So, here we are. Claws and Convo is brought to you by Awesome and by our patrons There I go, skipping my brain around. I can't keep my thoughts in a straight line. My thoughts are not linear or circular. They're sporadic. Claws and Combo is brought to you by Awesome, produced here at Strikepaw Studios, aka wherever the hell I happen to be living, currently in Bloomfield, Iowa, hosted here out of my apartment, and sponsored by our patrons and donators and donors. The hardest part of producing a show while hosting it is trying to type in links in the show, in the chat, while still trying to fill dead air. It's hard to type and talk at the same time sometimes. You know how it is, right? Yeah. So yeah, there's the Patreon. I'll check that to make sure it works. That works. Yep. Patreon rewards may include a sketch commission from moi, and among other things. And yeah, if you have any ideas for anything that I might be able to provide as the Patreon wants, please feel free to make suggestions so I may consider them and instigate a sudden death of brain cells. Ebola. Just kidding, but I digress. So yes, Patreon will be the main funding source for all of the future equipment and upgrades and everything else required to keep the show running, including server costs for Strikepaw.com and the official Strikepaw and the official Claws and Combo website at clawsandcombo.strikepaw.com, and anyone else who happens to be supported on strikepaw.com. Keep in mind that I do provide some web space for those needing it, for those who are too poor to provide their own. So feel free to let me know, strikerchiguar at strikepaw.com. That is my personal email address, so yeah, drop me a line. Meanwhile, you can contact the show at studio email address is studio@strikepaw.com, or use the contact tab on the clausenconvo.strikepaw.com and use that contact form. Send in any of your local events, any of your news, any of your interesting topics, anything you want to be covered on the show and future episodes. Or if I catch it during this episode, I'll talk about it in this episode, because there's nothing to talk about in this episode. But speaking about this episode, if you want to call in and be a guest on this episode, Skype line is open. Username is Claws and Convo. So if you want to call in and talk about anything at all, tell us how you got into the furry fandom and tell us what the furry fandom means to you, or just rant about what pissed you off this morning, etc. No topic today, but yeah, it's a hangout time show. At least for today. Until we have actual subjects! Subjects that we do not have! Meanwhile, you know, plans to move to Indianola are proceeding slowly. Maybe a year or two before I'm actually able to move. Meanwhile, I'll be looking for places to live. And since it'll be something like this, sort of a subsidized public housing thing. Because I'm poor. I am very poor. And it is getting very cold. Winter is approaching. It is coming very quickly, and in Iowa, it can be a lot of fun. Especially when, like me, you have balding tires on your rear-wheel drive vehicle, and fun will ensue. Although it helps to have four-wheel drive, so it's not gonna be terrible. The one thing that I can't stand during the winter is being snowed in. I can't stand not being able to go places because of a few inches of snow. That's not going to stop me. Thus, every vehicle that I have owned has been a four-wheel drive vehicle. Because I can't stand sitting still. I like having capability. I like going places. I like being useful. And, so my Ranger, naturally, is a four-wheel drive Ranger. And it gets me around. Episode 3, we had Yodi call in, and we had a little talk about our vehicles. Yodi has a Toyota pickup, and of course I talk about my Ranger. That just gives you an example of how versatile this show is. Now we can talk about anything. So often it just wanders off away from furry topics, and that's okay because it's entertaining. Right? I hope so. Well, yeah, my fursuit will be completed in time for MFF, and it's currently being made by Sandy Darkpaw Creations. I think in the chat, darkpawcreations.com. Damn it! http://. There! You bastard! Yeah, that's what I address. But yeah, that is who was working on my first seed at the moment. And it is very close to completion. I believe I have some pictures on here. Well, I've... There's a head with the fur pattern on it. That's the blue stuff right there. It's a fur pattern. And yeah, that hair is the exact same color as my hair. That's why when I saw this, I had to check, see if someone sneaked in during that and cut my hair off. But yeah, that is a perfect match for my hair. That is, and those eyes are perfect. And the market, the deer lines are perfect. It's obviously not what it's going to look like in the end, but you can kind of get an idea what the markings are going to look like. On the pattern here. And that is going to look incredible. That's fucking awesome. That is going to be awesome. So, what we're going to do now is we're going to play a radio drama called Kaze, Winds of Change. Via YouTube. Meanwhile, if you want to call in, the Skype lines are open. So call in and hang out while this thing is playing. And yeah, we'll be back in a moment.
Kaze? Where are you? Wait, who's there? This is my garden. Show yourself. Kaze, is that you? Please, Kaze, if that's you, show yourself.
Bay, it's me.
Kaze, stop doing that. You almost scared me.
I'm sorry, but this time it's for real. I had to make certain you were alone.
What's going on?
Oh no. You don't know, do you?
Kaze? What's wrong? Something's not right. What is it?
It's your father. He's been assassinated.
That's not funny. Don't even pretend such a thing.
Tombe, Field Marshal Tsukuru has assumed control of the palace. Your mother has been moved to a safe location, and now we must do the same for you.
Oh my gods. You're serious? My father is dead?
Shh! The killer could be here. If this is a coup...
Can't you save him? Come on, you'll see a training. Pull him back.
Oh, darling, I can heal, but I can't resurrect.
No. No. No!
I'm here, babe. I'm here for you.
We should have run away together. Left this royal prison when we had the chance.
No, my love. These threads, they can't be changed. Even if we had run away, your father would still have been killed.
We would have each other.
Bay! How long do you think a tiger and cheetah could hide without getting caught?
We could have left Tira, run to the wildlands, go to that little farm you raised, be my husband. We could live where my father's armies could never find us. Where we could live the rest of our days as simple people. People whose lives are their own to do with as they wish.
Oh, if that were within my power, that would be a dream come true, my lady. My heart belongs to you, Bay. From the first moment I saw you, my heart was no longer my own. And I cherish knowing that I am yours somehow. Bay, I kneel before you, my princess.
Kaze.
By my life, I give that I am. This body's blood, this warrior's spirit, my very soul itself. By my gods and ancestors, I give you all that I am in every lifetime. And in this lifetime, I pledge, by my living or my dying, I will always keep you safe. Kimo was right. I have to get you out of here.
No, stay here. If you leave your post, they will think that you had something to do with this. I'll find Kima and have her take me to your old farm.
But how will she know?
Her clan is from the wildlands. She knows the area.
You're the only one that I've told.
She's mute, not deaf. And I know she hears a lot more than she lets on.
Over here! Flank right! Flank right!
Then go. Go fast. I will find you and bring you home again. I promise.
You had everything, and you wasted on what can never be, that a peasant and a princess would presume to love and think they can survive. As long as I defend the kingdom, you will never ascend the throne. Never!
Kaze, Winds of Change, is brought to you by the support of Drafilius, Gavin Lumiere, Justin Paul Reese, producer of Radio Universe, and by the Australian Dragons. Directed and produced by Amadhia. Written by Amadhia and DC King. Starring Trent Sparks as Kaze, Nicola Kinsman as Princess Bay, and Nico Janssen as Tesso. Featuring the voice talents of Amadhia, DC King, Ronnie Callan, Ryan McClendon, and Justin P. Reese as the announcer. With Jacob Williamson and DC King as associate producers, and J. Mateo Baker as audio director. Music by Fox Amore and Nicola Kinsman, aka Lilypad. Animatic version featuring artwork in order of appearance by Thornwolf, Bala, Elector Fencer, and Bloodhound Omega. And now, Episode 1, Born of Fire.
Our story doesn't begin here. It begins many years ago.
Kemen. Kemen, darling. How is your work going?
Just a few more minutes, Lisanne. I'm almost done.
Well, finish up soon. Supper's ready.
By my stripes, look at the sun. I really lost track of time today, didn't I?
So, let's see this blade that has taken my husband away from me on such a perfect day. Oh, Kemen. Oh, it's beautiful.
Aw, oh, thanks. It's only just beginning to take shape, really.
May I? Here, trade you. Hold Kaze a moment.
Come here, little cub. Let's let Mommy play with the sharp toys.
The sword's balance. It's perfect.
Oh, little Kaze. You've got your mama's stripes. You know that, don't you? You're gonna grow up to be stronger than your papa and even better with a sword than mama, won't you? Won't you?
Oh, Kemen. You say you're not a weaver, but the blades you craft, my love, they're simply magical. I'd swear you were trained by the Sia.
I doubt the monks would let a tiger anywhere near their monasteries. Remember? We're too dangerous. Ow! Kaze! Mind those claws, little guy.
It's okay, love. I'll get them. Smells like you've got customers. I'll put water on for tea. Kaze! Kaze! You come back here, you little ermine.
Hello, miss.
Sorry, this ain't your lucky day.
Ow! That little brat bit me!
Don't let him get away. We can sell him.
What are you doing with... Get away from my son!
I'm not going to spoil it. Link in the... They will link this in the chat. If you want to watch the rest of this, damn it. Click the wrong button. Okay, I'll link going up in the chat if you want to watch the rest of this episode. And subscribe to Amadhia if you want to see more episodes of Kaze, Winds of Change. And be sure to support Kaze, Winds of Change in any way you can, because it is an amazing story. But, yeah. Definitely worth a look. So, we have reached and exceeded the 30-minute mark. So, yeah, we're going to take a little bit of a break, and I'll reopen the Skype line for anyone who wants to call in during the break. There we go. So, we'll do our usual Ensaam music during our little, probably like a 5 to 10 minute break. It'll be back. We'll be right back. You are watching Claws and Convo. Coming back from a very brief break as we listen to a little bit of Kiar and Sam. And my camera's all blurry because it is lame. Manual focus. There we go. Manual focus override. Now would auto focus correctly? Yes, it will. So, yes, instead of the demon autofocus, I will kill you. Stay over here. There. Don't even you. Alright, so, now before the break, we featured Kaze, Winds of Change. Just a little taste of the radio drama produced by Amadhia. And of course now we're playing some music from Ensaam because why not? And by the way, they have an album out, just released, called New Kingdom Symphony, $7 on Bandcamp, so do check that out. Link in the description. I'm not gonna bother fixing that because you can copy and paste. I'm lazy. So the Skype lines are open for anyone who wants to call in. Once again, there is no topic for the show today. It's just going to be a hangout type of show, because no idea what else to talk about today. No topics whatsoever. I would like to have an actual topic to talk about, because that's kind of point of the show, but, you know, that's good to just have one of these anything goes type of shoot the breeze. So it's just to get the things rolling a little, keep things going. And I am looking for co-hosts to are regularly available to call in on Skype. And of course, everyone is welcome to call in on Skype. The username is Claws and Convo. But a full-time host would be a great thing. If anyone would be available to do so. Turn that down just a hair. But, yeah. Claws and Convo is, of course, brought to you by yours truly, strikepaw.com, and sponsored entirely by donations and Patreon, both of which have zero activity, so it's all out of my own pocket because, yeah. So, yeah, it's... to give you a little bit of background on the show, last year we had Dante Padfoot as a in-studio co-host. We actually produced a show in his apartment using his computer, which, yeah, it kind of worked. And we were also on Ustream as well, which was good for, I guess, actual having visibility, I guess. But it had problems. But now we got first stream. The beginning of this year, I moved, or I guess in the middle of this year, I don't know. I moved here to Bloomfield and had my whole studio set up here. And unfortunately, Dante was not able to make the trip down here to do the show for reasons. So, I ended up restarting season 2 by myself, in the hopes that someone would eventually join me. And here we are, episode 4 of Claws and Convo. No co-hosts found yet. No co-hosts have come in yet, so that's still kind of open. And, you know, not necessarily look for in-studio co-hosts, I suppose, at the moment, just because I am going to be moving to Indianola at some point. So it won't be a very, I guess, proficient idea to look for in-studio co-hosts, at least not yet until I've completed the move. So that's going to be kind of a back, sort of the down the line sort of thing. But in the meantime, you know, temporary guest hosts in studio would be a great thing. So if anyone's local here and can make the trip to Bloomfield weekly, then you're more than welcome to come down and hang out and be on the show as a guest co-host. And as always, Skype line. You can always Skype in and be a guest throughout the entire show and just kind of hang out. Sometimes we might have a topic, sometimes we don't. Usually we don't because I'm too lazy to come up with things, but overall, yeah, just come in, hang out, chill, talk about anything, pretty much. Generally, I like to ask calling guests about how they got into the fandom and how the furry fandom affects their lives and that kind of thing. So, yeah, if you want to talk about that, call in. Your username is Claws and Convo on Skype. Focus kind of screwy. Is that good? Manual focus. Yeah, because autofocus is kind of screwing up. But I digress from camera issues. Of course, we got the Patreon going. Patreon.com/Strikepaw. Your help, we can kind of not only buy better stuff to improve the show and help in-studio guests and future co-hosts to pad their gas, but of course it'll go to buying a camera and studio hardware, and of course I do need a new camera if we get another guest, because there's no way to position this camera right here to proficiently get everyone in the shots. So that's one thing that I'll help fund. I also help fund StrikePod.com server hosted on domain.com, and if it's as long as the StrikePaw.com is up and running, I can help you, dear content producer watching this. I can help you if you're too poor to provide yourself with a server with the web space. I will, if you so desire, I can provide you with a subdomain on StrikePaw.com with FTP access. So, save yourself a little bit of money, help yourself get off the ground, and become part of the Strikepaw Network. This is also sponsored by our Patreon. And, as well, Of course, as I said, studio upgrade and maintenance. I absolutely need to get better cables and get the upgrades for the studio computer. And my secondary monitor looks like it's got a few pixels that are kind of fading. And that's probably going to go bad, so I'll probably need a new secondary monitor. And among other things, so that'll help. So Patreon will help cover that. And if it really picks up, I'll be able to. If it really takes off, then I might actually be able to put more time into this and maybe produce other shows or so on, and maybe start new shows, maybe, you know, just maybe make some videos and stuff here and there. It'll be more of a full-time job if it really takes off, and it'll all be all thanks to you, dear patrons, on our Patreon. And yeah, one of the rewards includes a sketch commission from yours truly, which is very rare for me. I almost never do commissions, and this is one of those rare exceptions I will consider. I forgot to turn my spears off, so I apologize for any echo that might have occurred. Anyway, yeah, it'll go into that. Sketch submission from me at the $30 level. There's a limit of 4, I believe. So, yeah, you can just pay whatever, like $1, $5, $10 per episode. And I'll occasionally throw in a free one, just for the hell of it. So, yeah. Sign up, get on Patreon, and support this show, and maybe we'll come up with some more topic to talk about, stuff to talk about. We're always looking for stuff to talk about, so, you know, get on clausandcombo.strikepaw.com, send in your suggestions to the show for topics and anything like that. If you've got something you want to feature, then go ahead, write that ahead, and link it in the chat or on the contact page of clausandcombo.strikepaw.com. I will be awaiting your suggestions. Yes, this is supposed to be a conversational type of podcast. You can call it a podcast. Because sometimes I forget to actually archive it. Anyway. And yeah, it's really intended to be a live show. So a recorded version might have a few bits cut out for so it doesn't get booted from YouTube. And one of the funding goals is for on Patreon is to actually be able to upload the full uncut recorded episode on directly to the Claus and Convo website, so we do not have to rely on YouTube. But now in the meantime, we're kind of reliant upon YouTube, so hopefully in the future we can do something to improve In that sort of way, I guess. I don't know. I'm scatterbrained. Have you noticed? I'm sure you have. So, yeah. The music in the background you're hearing is from Ensaam. Well, I like playing their music on the show because, number one, it doesn't get the DMCA claim on YouTube, and YouTube doesn't catch it, so I can get away with playing it in the background. And of course, I've been linking there. I have a link to their website in the credits of the recorded episode, so yeah. Ensaam.bandcamp.com. $7, you can get their new album, New Kingdom Symphony.
It's really hard to fill dead air when you're all alone. Really difficult. So, yeah, we're about 1 hour into this show. Still kind of waiting here for people to call in and have a little chat. A little conversation. Hang out. You know, that kind of thing. Central Iowa Fur Meat Group is looking into a new venue for their regular meat. More on that in future episodes, hopefully. And yeah, probably in the future we'll be considering starting that little convention because we are getting fairly big, fairly fast, and Iowa definitely needs a convention. Back in 2012, there was a sort of a movement to start Iowa Fur Convention, which I was sort of a part of, but unfortunately, no. There was some drama and drama kills, and then the rights were, someone else took over as chairman, and it kind of just fell apart and just lost momentum. And once it lost momentum, it just kind of died out. So it's a bit unfortunate, but now hopefully with this new group, we can get something put together. That will be of ultimate awesomeness. Now, it's, you know, during that, during the whole FoxyCon thing, you know, the common argument was, Iowa didn't really need a convention. It wasn't big enough. The community wasn't big enough. To which I say, bullshit, bullshit. It's probably big enough. So, just saying, Iowa needs a fur convention. And our focus is way off again. I will say that's perfect. Okay. Yes, Iowa does need a fur convention. And, we've kind of been talking about that with the Central Iowa Fur Group. And it's just, you know, not making any promises, not saying that there's going to be a convention. But, yeah, it's just kind of been floating around as something worth considering. It's just kind of, it's a concept that we've just kind of been bouncing around. And if that does actually catch on and we actually end up going for it, then why is the camera not, it's on manual focus. Stop that. There. Stay. But anyway, yeah, if we do end up pushing forward with the convention idea, then I will definitely be a part of the whole push. What question is, what will I do? What will be my place? I'll definitely be in charge of the, I can definitely see myself taking part, being the sound tech for the main stage, if that happens, but, you know, I'm just kind of just, you know, throwing ideas out there. So, yes. Now I work for a convention. Can we make it happen? Call in, let's talk about that. I am not going to be the chairman. Just saying. That is not my title. I'm the guy that the chairman goes to deal with shit that no one else wants to deal with. If you know what I mean. I'm the evil henchman. Not really. No. Nah. But yes. Now I would love to have a fur convention. That would be the greatest thing ever. And I will definitely be on the convention staff of said convention, and I would be the guy running audio for the main stage, and I would be running about and doing this and that, and maybe in charge of security. I don't know. I could do security, possibly. But yeah, I don't really know. We'll definitely have an ear to ground to listen in on the whole concept as it develops in the back of the mind of all of us here in the Central Iowa Fur Group. And we are right now a very quickly growing fur meet, and now that is an excellent starting point for any convention, because you can kind of got something to gain traction off of, something to jump off of, and there's already a support group there. So, from a fur meet, you can then jump forward and push onward and grow into something even more epic. A fur meet. A fur convention. Fur convention. There's some paperwork involved with fur conventions. Legal paperwork. And, kind of have to be, incorporated or LLC or something of that nature. Just mostly just to be on the safe side. Just so you have some kind of protection, I guess you could say. As well as legally. So there are a lot of furry conventions that are... A lot of furry conventions, at least, at least as far as the smaller conventions go, they're basically... especially with the really small conventions, they're basically just massive fur meets with a lot of paperwork in the background. So, that's kind of how things start off with said conventions. And, in Iowa, I think we're definitely going to be heading in that direction. This is just speculation, but, I'd say we're going for it. I would speculate that we are going for a convention. It's a very strong possibility. When might it happen? Well, probably, I would guess 2016. 2016 is what I would project as a possible starting year. 2016 or 2017. And it mainly because it just takes a couple of years just to get everything planned out. And then, as soon as the first year's over, it takes, you have to start planning for the next one. Almost before that first one gets started. So yeah, there is a lot involved in the convention. A lot. But yeah, Furfest. Furfest has moved their convention to December 5th to the 7th. I'm so excited. My fursuit will be done. Got a partial from Darkpaw. Yes. So, email. Nothing going on there. Nothing going on here. Absolutely nothing going on. So, I'm gonna go ahead and close this episode off. Cue up an outro music. And we're creating the outro sequence. Initiated. Habla habla. Unless someone calls in which case I will delay the end until after that conversation which conspires ends. So, last call for call-in. This is the final call, your last chance to call into the show. Skype username is Claws and Convo. These glasses are horrible. You may notice I have duct tape for nose pads. I'll be so glad when my new one come in. These things suck. Well, thanks for tuning in and watching this fourth episode of Claws and Convo. I have been Strike a Chiguire. I'll be sure to tune in next week for the next episode. Maybe we'll have a topic, maybe we won't, but either way, and that outro just fucked up. There. Now it'll loop. So yeah, thank you for tuning in for this rather slow going little episode here of Claws and Convo number 4 of a reloaded series because of reasons. Clawsandconvo.strikepaw.com is our official site. And I wonder if this thing fading out. I hope not. So yeah, Clausencode.strikepaw.com. Check out the Patreon and be a guest on the show on the next episode. It's Friday, 5 o'clock Central Standard Time. Hopefully, you all know that daylight savings time's ended. Clausencode.strikepaw.com. Patreon. Feel free to be on the show anytime you want in future episodes. Add us on Skype, Klaus and Convo. And, yada yada yada, blah blah blah. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Strikepaw Studios, on YouTube. And be sure to check out Kaze, Winds of Change, as produced by Amadhia. And also, you can check out my stuff on YouTube. Once again, I'm Striker Chiwa, producer and reluctant host of Claws and Convo. Signing off. Rock hard, live free, keep it true, and I'll be seeing you.